Welcome to the third chapter of the Sapphire course. In this chapter, I'll show you what message templates are and how to use them. First, let me send a message in Discord. I'll type hello. This is just a normal text message. Now, I'll send a message using Sapphire. This is an embed message. It has a dark background, a blue bar on the left, an image on the right, and many other features. You might be wondering, do all messages sent by Sapphire look like this? The answer is no. Normal Discord users like you and me can only send text messages. But Discord bots like Sapphire can send both text messages and embed messages. Embed messages look better and have more options. You can do a lot with them, and I'll show you how to customize them later in this video. Now, let's talk about templates. Sometimes you want to send the same message multiple times. Instead of typing it over and over, you can save it as a template. This way, you can send it anytime without retyping it. Sapphire uses this template system for all messages. You can create a template and use it however you like. Let me show you how to create your first message template and send it to Discord. First, go to the Sapphire dashboard. From the sidebar, click on Messages. You'll see a button called Create New Template. This button only appears if you don't have any templates yet. Click on it. It will ask you to name your template. I'll name it Hello. Remember, template names must be in lowercase, and you can use up to 26 characters, including letters, numbers, underscores, and dashes. After that, click Add. This will open the template editor. By default, you'll be on the preview page. To edit the template, click the Edit tab at the top. Now, you can edit the message. For now, I'll click the clear button to remove any existing content. I'll type Hello, which is the content for this template. Next, click the Use tab at the top. Choose a channel and click Send Message. This will send your template to the channel you selected. Let's go to Discord and see if the message was sent. Here it is, our message template. Now, back on the dashboard, you'll see I didn't click the Save Changes button before sending the template. That's because you don't need to save changes for Sapphire to send the template right away. But if I refresh my browser, any changes I made to the template will be lost. To keep the changes, click the Save Changes button. Think of this like taking a snapshot of your template to save it in Sapphire's database. Earlier on this chapter, I mentioned you only see the New Templates button if you don't have any templates, so now I'll show you how to create a new template if you already have one. If you already have a message template, then you don't see any buttons on this page, so click on this Templates option. Then from here you have to use this Create New Template button. If you want to edit an existing template, then just click on the template name, and you can edit it from here. As you use Sapphire more, you will have a lot of templates here, and it will be hard to manage them, so you can create folders to categorize them. Click on this folder icon, then here all of your folders will show. I don't have any folders, so this list is empty. Let's create a new folder. First, type a name for our folder, then click the plus icon. Now our template is inside this folder. You can also remove it from this folder. To remove it, click the folder icon. It shows the current folder name highlighted with blue color. And from here you can remove the template from the folder by clicking on the folder name, or you can move it to a different folder by clicking on the other folder's name that you want to move this template to. Here we have a search box, which allows to find templates and folders by name. Below the search box you have this option, Show Folder. Enabling this will show the folders. Disabling this will show all templates, but won't remove the templates from the folders. Also, if you enable this option and search for something on the search box, then it only shows result for the folder name, not the template. So you have to keep it in mind while using the search feature. If you want to delete a template, then just click this X icon near the folder icon to delete the template. Keep in mind that once you delete a template, you cannot restore it. We have covered the very basics of message templates. Now I'll teach you the more advanced things. I'll create a new template, give it a name, tutorial, and clear the existing message content. Now I will add an embed to the template by clicking this plus embed button. You can create multiple embeds by clicking this plus embed button, and if you want to delete an embed, click this X icon here. As of making this course, you can't order of these embeds, so keep that in mind while creating embeds inside your templates. To change the color of this embed, just click on it and it will give you two options. You can either enter your color as hex value or click this color box to pick a color. If you enter any messages here, then it will show outside of the embed. Here we have author name. It's a small text which shows above the title. If you type an author name, then two options will show up, author image and author link. Clicking the image icon will ask you enter a URL for your image. Here I'll enter Sapphire's logo link. If I go to the preview tab, then we can see the Sapphire logo from the URL I just entered. The preview tab shows how the message will look if it is sent to a channel on Discord. It is not perfect, but it's a good to have feature. If we click on this link icon, then it will ask to enter a URL. Clicking the author name will take you to this URL. Next is title. The title is basically a big bold text. Description is normal text. Here you can use markdown, emoji, links, and so on. Fields have two text areas. One is field title and other is field description. They work same as the titles and descriptions up here, but fields have a special purpose. If you add two or more fields and enable these checkboxes, then they will show up vertically like this. Footer text is same thing as the author text we can earlier, but you cannot add links to the text here. There is a small calendar icon here. The footer text are mostly used to show time. If you click on the calendar icon, you will see two options. Here you can enter Unix timestamp, and by clicking this calendar icon, you can pick a time to show on the footer. We have two image options here. This will show the image below all these titles, descriptions, and fields. The image on this right side will show the image on right side like this. You cannot upload images directly here, so first you have to upload the image to an image hosting services and enter the link to the image here. Here on top we have three tabs. We are currently in Visual tab. Now let's jump to Raw tab. On the Raw tab, we can see the raw data of the template we just edited. Whenever we make changes to the template on the Visual tab, the codes you see here on Raw tab will be updated. You should not play around with this Raw tab unless you know what you are doing, because a simple mistake here will make your template not usable. The next tab is Variables. Think of variable as a box. You can store things inside of it and change the things inside of it anytime. You cannot create new variables, but Sapphire have a lot of default variables. Let's say you want to show the member count of your server on your message template. Instead of entering the member count manually, we can just use this guild member count variable. Just click on the variable name. This will copy the variable to our clipboard. Now get back to the Visual tab and paste the variable here. The variable always starts with a dollar sign, and it will have the variable name inside curly braces. If we send this template to our server now, Sapphire will check the member count of our server and replace the variable with the member count number. Member counts changes very frequently on servers, so using this variable will give you the accurate member count at the time of sending this message. Keep in mind that not all variables work on all of your message templates. You will see the variables supported on your template on this variables list. If you add a button or drop down to your message, then you will see new variables on this list. We will get into that in a different chapter on this course. Now I'll show how you can use Markdown on your messages, then we will move to adding emoji, mentions, and so on. With Markdown, you can change how your message looks like. I'll go to Discord and show you how to use Markdown on your messages, then I'll show you how to use them on Sapphire message templates. If I type hi, it will send as a normal text message. Now if I add a hashtag or pound sign in front of the text, then this text will appear big. This is a heading 1 markdown text. Like this, you can do few cool things with markdown. If you type 2 hashtag, then the text will appear slightly smaller than text before. The more hashtag you add, the more smaller the text appears. Next is list markdown. You can put a dash in front of your text and it will look like a bullet point. If you add a space in front of the dash, then it will look like subitem. Keep in mind the spaces in between the words and the symbols are very important. Final markdown is hyperlinks. First type square brackets like this, then type parentheses like this. Now enter a text inside the square brackets, then enter your link inside the parentheses. When you send this message, it will show it as hyperlink like this. You can use these markdown on Sapphire message templates. Keep in mind that these markdown won't work on titles, field name, author name, and footer text. This is a Discord limitation, so keep this in mind when you try to use Markdown on your message templates. Now I'll show how you can use emoji on the templates. First, I'll come to Discord and select emoji. Before I send it, I'll add a backslash in front of the emoji and send it. Now you will see this angle brackets and emoji ID. Just copy this and paste it on your message template. If I send this template to a channel, then we can see the emoji in the template. Next is user mention. Instead of sending emoji, I'll send the user ping. In my case, it's just my Discord name. Now copy this and paste it on our message template on Sapphire. Keep in mind that if you put this inside the embed, then this user won't get pinged or receive a notification that they are pinged. This is because mentions inside the embed won't ping users. So if you want to ping the user, then you have to put this outside of the embed like this. To mention a role, exactly the same procedure as mentioning a user. To mention a channel, exactly the same procedure as mentioning a user. The final mention is slash command. This is bit tricky one. First go to your account settings, then go to advanced, then enable this developer mode option. Now go to your server settings, then go to integrations, then click on the bot name which has the command you want to mention. In my case, it is Sapphire. Scroll down till you see the slash command on this commands list. Now right-click on the command name, you will see the option, copy command ID. Click on this option so the command ID will be saved to your clipboard. Now on Sapphire message template, type angle brackets like this, then type slash and enter your command name. For me, it is help. Keep in mind that you should type the command name correctly here. Then add a colon and paste the command ID here. If I send this template to a channel, we can see the slash command as mention on the message. Next, I'll show you how you can edit a message template already sent into the channel. First, I'll go to Discord and copy the message link. Keep in mind that to edit a message, the message should be sent by Sapphire. Now on the template editor, I'll make some changes to this template. I'll now go to the Use tab, then go to the Edit tab, and enter the message link here. If you click this Edit Message button, Sapphire will edit the message of the message link with the content of this template we have. So first you have to prepare your template, then enter the message link here, and click on the Edit Message button to edit your message. You can also send the message using a webhook. To do that, simply enable this webhook option and paste your webhook URL here. There is an easy way to create a new message template using the content of the message already sent by Sapphire. First, copy the link of the message you want to use. Then create a new template or open an existing template and click this load option. Then you can enter the message link of the message here, then click this checkmark. Now the message template will be updated with the content of message on the message link. Don't worry, other people cannot duplicate your message templates by using this message link method. This method only works on the server you have managed server or admin permissions. You can clone your other templates, just click this option, and it will show you a drop-down list of all the templates you have. Right now it's empty because I don't have any other templates here. I want to share one useful tip about this raw tab. If you want to share your template with other people, then you can simply copy the raw code from here and send it to others. The other person just have to create a new template and replace the raw code with the code you give it to them. The last thing I want to cover of this chapter is default messages. Right now you know all the basics of the message templates, so this is the best time to show you around the default message. On the messages page, click on default message. Here you will see all the message templates used by Sapphire, and you can edit them however you want. Click the pencil icon to edit the template. This is a message template Sapphire sends on DM when someone gets banned from your server, and you can customize this to your likings. Here you can see a lot of new variables used on the template, and on variables tab, you can see new variables like case ID, user tag, and so on. On the top, we have two options. Sapphire adds some emoji on the title of the message for certain default messages. You can turn off this behavior by turning off this option here. This remove empty lines is related to variables. Let's say this message has a proof variable, but if the proof message is not available, then this variable will be empty, so Sapphire will show a slash indicating the variable is empty. This won't look good in some cases, so you can enable the Remove Empty Lines option to make Sapphire remove the entire line if the variable is empty. The variable will be on this template, but Sapphire will just remove it on the message it sends. That's it for this chapter. This is a pretty big chapter, which took around 3 days to finish. I hope I covered everything about message templates on this chapter. On the next chapter, I'll show you how you can use message components like buttons and drop-down menus.